Saw
3D.
Oh,
I remember this.
Somebody help us!
By the events of Saw 3D, Jigsaw no longer has any issue with going public with his traps.
Hello, Brad. Hello, Ryan. And I'll play a game.
Hey.
Remember that time when I said I was going to play a video game and how distracted I get? God damn it, bro. This whole stream went off the rails, bro. I blame Spice, bro.
Freedom.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 20 Saw traps.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. If you want your head to pop off like that.
Your traps help me a long way, thanks.
You can! Go move now!
This is good, because I don't really remember all the traps, bro. I remember the OG traps, but I don't remember a lot of the traps.
For this list, we'll be looking at the most effective games that Jigsaw and his apprentices created during this long-running horror thriller series. These are based...
Yeah, I was going to play a game, and then you subbed. And then I was like, and it reminded me, oh, let me watch Nuketown 5 first instead. And then we went off the rails after that.
On their entertainment value, how well they tie into the plot, and the way they align with Jigsaw's philosophy of appreciating life. So which Saw traps haunted your nightmares? Let us know in the comments. Now on to the gory top 20.
Sucked.
Number 20, Oxygen Crusher, Saw 6. After William Easton is abducted, he wakes up to find this trap, also known as the breathing room, as his first test.
The only escape is in the other's failure.
The objective is to outlive the opponent, with the victims hooked to a machine that detects their breathing and progressively puts pressure on their chest.
Hold your breath.
It's an effective trap that rules out any chance of cheating, as the character's breaths are taken into account no matter how much they try to get away with it. The only issue is the unfairness of the situation, as William's opponent is a man riddled with heart disease, which basically sets him up to fail. Still, the tension felt in this scene is hard to miss, especially when the...
Yo, he's an asshole for this. I forgot how much Jigsaw was an asshole, bro. This man's just setting people up. He's like throwing alley-oops for traps, bro.
Hey, yo.
So petty, bro. Holy
shit. Trap
shit.
Reaches its crushing conclusion. Number 19, Pendulum Trap, Saw 5.
Hello, Seth. I want to play a game.
The fifth movie's opening shows Seth Baxter, a convicted criminal, let out on a technicality, bound to a metal table when his game begins. The rules seem simple enough, with the only way out by activating a mechanism that forces Seth to offer his hands to save his life.
You must insert your hands and push the buttons to start the devices before you.
The motivation to complete this painful task is the presence of a pendulum blade that swings closer towards Seth unless he completes the requirement.
Oh my god!
Unfortunately, this trap is rigged by Mark.
Nah, these deaths are way more elaborate, bro, than obviously than Final Destination. Like, how do writers come up with these type of shit, bro? Like, bruh, who is thinking of this? Watch this video, it's messed up. I'll look, I'll see. He has a reason for each trap that made it worse. Yeah, I think I remember that.
Mark Hoffman, who uses it as a way to avenge Seth's killing
Sneak
of his sister.
Hello.
Seth did deserve to pay for his crimes, but there's no denying he did win this trap fair and square. It also leads to Jigsaw capturing Hoffman for copying his MO and setting him up as his apprentice. Number 18. Horsepower Trap, Saw 3D.
Hello, Heaven. I want to play a game.
Appropriately called the Horsepower Trap, this game involves the main subject being glued to a car seat, with the goal being to reach for the lever to free not only himself, but a number
Remember
of his friends.
This.
The price of failure is the resulting chain of deaths, as the car is intended to release and cause a painful end
Remember
to these characters.
This shit, bro.
True to its nature, the trap carries a sense of urgency, as the man literally tears himself apart to pull the lever. Unfortunately, the timer runs out anyway, spelling everyone's doom, as in the end, his efforts don't matter. Considering so many lives are on the line here, this game represents how Jigsaw considers life to be a race against time. Number 17, Drill Chair, Saw.
Awake already, Jeff.
I interview psychopaths.
I need more powerful tranquilizers next time.
The Drill Chair is a simple but terrifying game, as the victim is left at the mercy of another person to prevent a truly awful demise.
Now you'll make a choice. In 20 seconds, the life of this man will be ended.
Shut up and get down here!
What did you do? Turn it off!
It's not known what the actual game was meant to be here, as Jigsaw activates it to distract detectives away from him.
Tell him how to stop it, asshole!
One key will unlock it.
Where is it?
When Sing and Tap find the hapless Jeff strapped to this chair, they have precious few moments to figure out how to save the man. Their attempts to use the keys to unlock his binds is never really an option, however, not with the drills approaching dangerously close to Jeff. In the end, Sing cleverly shoots the drills instead, providing a rare example of a character quick-thinking their way out of a game. Number 16, Classroom Trap, Saw 3. Troy finds himself chained to a chair in a classroom, where he receives instructions that the only way to be free is to pull on the chains pierced into his body.
Oh my god.
You are in freedom.
As expected, this is far from an easy task, although Troy does muster a remarkable level of willpower to come close.
All he had to do was release himself from each of the chains.
However, certain chains are pierced in vital areas that can be ripped open, leaving Troy at the hands of death. This is one of the traps executed by Amanda Young, who developed a habit to make them inescapable. The impressive aspect of this is the symbolism it carries, as Troy had to break himself apart from the criminal lifestyle that had shackled him for years. Number 15, Needle Pit, Saw 2. The Nerve Gas House has several traps specifically for certain characters, with the Needle Pit being a representation of beating addiction.
Originally meant as
a test for Xavier, it takes a different turn when he forces Amanda to do it instead.
I remember he threw the shit out of her in this. Oh my god, bro. I don't like needles, yo. Oh, I have to look away every time the doctor try to give me a needle, bro.
There isn't just one needle, but several hundred that form a pit where the key is hidden. Unlike most Jigsaw traps, this one doesn't carry any lethal consequences. That doesn't make the process of sifting through hundreds of stabbing needles any more pleasant for Amanda. Her success points towards her survivalist attitude, and would have been a success had it not been for Xavier's Butterfingers.
He's a former junkie too, yeah.
Number 14. Pound of Flesh.
Oh my god, bro. I still get the chance. I'm not like a full on, like, you know, those people that just be like, oh my god, no. Like, I just be like, oh, just hurry up and do it. Hurry up and just give me the needle already. I don't like, I still be doing it in a manly way, but I just look away, you know? I'd be like, just hurry up and take the blood, bro. Hurry up, man.
Ah. Saw 6. The games become more brutal with each film, and the sixth installment begins with Eddie and Simone being selected for a test where only one can survive.
The devices on your heads are symbolic of the shackles that you place upon others. You recklessly loan people money.
This is based on who can provide the most flesh before the timer runs out. Losing means getting one skull drilled in by the mechanism on their head.
Who will offer the most flesh
I remember
in order to save their life? The choice is yours.
Holy. And no, I don't ask for a lollipop, bro. Sometimes they just be having it in a bowl and you just take it.
With a distinct advantage, Eddie immediately begins handing out his offerings, prompting Simone to think of drastic measures. With seconds left, she braves through the fear and offers up her arm to win as a horrified Eddie.
Yo, they wildin' in this film, bro. I know they're not gonna show it on YouTube, but like they
meets his end.
Just having remembering these sharks, shits.
The two are given a gruesome realization that feeding on others' miseries entails a vivid lesson from Jigsaw. Number 13, Angel Trap.
When I get the needle, I'd be like, just hurry up and look to my shoes. Nothing to me. I'd be like, I'm doing this for real. I watched them take blood like a freak. God damn, Spice. God damn, man. The fuck is wrong with you, Rock? God damn. She just staring at the doctor's eyes. God damn. You do that when you're given...
Saw 3.
Angel Trap.
This one is designed for those with the bravest of spirits, as sufficient pain needs to be incurred to escape. Allison wakes up to a trap fixed around her ribs.
Like, oh,
as Jigsaw explains,
here's a pit
the cost of
needles, of
failure
know, right?
will be Carrie experiencing
I
a terrible fate.
How Jigsaw made the charge based on people in the trap.
She undergoes the test by plunging her hand into acid and retrieving the key at the bottom.
Oh my God, I remember
achieving
this.
The goal with time to spare. Unfortunately, it turns out to be Amanda's inescapable trap, meaning Carrie has to suffer a tragic end to her life despite winning the game. The Angel Trap tests the victim's mental resolve as much as their willpower, as it tested Carrie's willingness to live compared to her capacity for pain. Number 12, Grain Silo Trap, Jigsaw.
I can't.
The games in Jigsaw vary in complexity, ranging from simpler tests like the Bucket Room.
We might have to watch a Saw, bro. We might have to watch a Saw. I need to get over this. I need to get over this. I need to become a Spice. Not an Ice Spice. Oh, no. I need to just be able to look the killer in the eye. I mean, what?
Room and Needle Trap to brain teasers like the Cycle Trap and the Shotgun Keys in the film's climax.
Here's your key to freedom.
The Grain Silo Trap technically shouldn't have been played, as Ryan begins it by trying and failing to escape. Things get worse when Anna and Mitch are trapped in the silo, as it's up to Ryan to free them at a great personal cost.
If he pulls the lever before you are buried alive, you will live.
Ryan, free yourself.
Wait, how many Saws are there? Because I don't remember any of these people.
This trap stands out in the movie for presenting a direct consequence for breaking Jigsaw's rules and giving a selfish character like Ryan a morally conscious decision to make. It's also fun to see how overboard Jigsaw went with placing dangerous weapons in the silo, bringing in an element of dark humor. Number 11, Shotgun Carousel, Saw 6.
Nine? God damn.
Jigsaw's practice of giving everybody
Does
a chance
that include
to live
Jigsaw?
Takes a twist
like the
in
movie?
This trap, as the possibility to stay alive for each participant is
That's
extremely
crazy.
Thin.
Six, ride the carousel.
That's so many. Was that Carl Winslow? I mean, Eddie Winslow from Family Matters? What the hell's going on? It never happened to me. He went from... it's alright to take a bullet in the freaking head.
Six, ride the carousel.
Freaking Eddie, man. What up, Allie?
William is given a choice to save
Damn,
two
I didn't
out
know
of six people
much,
strapped
yeah.
to a carousel, while the others can do nothing but stare down a shotgun barrel in their last moments. Along with the creative design of the carousel, the trap is a good depiction of how Williams' insurance policies appear if they're shown in the flesh, as the person who comes up with the best argument gets to live. Despite racking up a high kill count, the carousel's scary quality comes with a certainty of death involved.
Please! Reduce the quality!
Number 10, Pig Vat, Saw 3.
Wait, which one was that? Saw 4? That said Saw 4. I think I stopped at 3, bro, too. Not because I didn't want to watch them, I just forgot.
This trap is relatively lower in intensity compared to the others, although it's ultimately a stomach-churning one.
Get me out of here!
Jeff finds the judge who only gave the man that accidentally killed his son a short sentence at the bottom of a vat.
Now you have the power to sentence his soul straight to hell. Or
it's crazy.
You can forgive. The key that will free him is hidden inside your son's
Stop that
once.
It's hard not to grimace when several pigs' pulped remains begin flowing into the vat and
nearly
drown the judge. Jeff's task is simple enough, as he needs to burn the belongings of his son to retrieve the key to save the judge's life. However, there's a certain level of pain involved, as the morose Jeff is forced to let go of his son's memory. This trap proves Jigsaw is a master of doling out both physical and emotional pain.
Damn.
Number 9.
Damn. That's sad, bro. Damn, Jigsaw. I forgot how badass this mother was, man. God damn. Rest in peace, bitch. This girl's Spice is insane,
Knife chair.
Bro.
She's crazy, yo. Jigsaw considers every trap he designs as his form of poetic justice. And the knife chair is where he wrote his first verse.
Let me go.
I could let you go.
After losing his unborn child due to Cecil, Jigsaw, then known as John Kramer, loses his sense of morality and takes justice into his own hands.
I want to play a game.
Upon capturing Cecil,
yo, that man's voice is iconic, but I kind of didn't want to see his face. I was like, that's you? I was kind of mad about that. But that voice is iconic, bro.
John informs him that the key to Cecil's redemption is to press his face against the set of knives before him, thereby cleansing him of his sins.
Just lean forward.
Having always played against the rules in life, Cecil is forced to comply for once and gets a painful lesson on the consequences
the
of his
right
actions.
Here.
The knife chair is definitely crude in execution, but its success is what led to John turning into Jigsaw.
Insane, yeah.
Number 8, Jeff's final test, Saw 3. Using his penchant for double meanings and half-truths, Jigsaw gives Jeff the option to forgive the killer for all the things he's done.
I forgive you.
Jeff thinks he has no way to lose and takes it upon himself to end Jigsaw's life. Unfortunately, he's unaware that Jigsaw's survival is connected to his wife, Lynn's, whose shotgun collar will go off when Jigsaw dies.
Bitch.
A horrified Jeff learns that his test isn't only centered around forgiveness, but also holds the fates of other characters.
Now I will give you something to live for.
The brilliance of this trap is how it goes directly in with Peter Strom's own test, who arrives moments later as we see in the next film. The result of Jeff's test
is
also the key to Hoffman's escape, as he uses Jeff's
daughter to brand himself as a hero in the fifth installment.
Number 7, Public Execution Trap, Saw 3D.
Oh, I remember this.
Somebody help us!
By the events of Saw 3D, Jigsaw no longer has any issue with going public with his traps.
Hello, Brad. Hello, Ryan. I'm out to play a game.
This one was basically a way to end a love triangle, as the trap involved two men fighting for their romantic interest.
Let that bitch die! Yo, they let that bitch die, bro! They were like, wait, you were seeing both of us? That shit was so funny, bro. You were dating both of us?
One person has to die by directing the saw in the other's direction. While Ryan and Brad start off by taking their rivalry to the lethal degrees, they come to realize the girl they're fighting over doesn't have genuine feelings for either of them.
You love him?
No! No!
Oh, you love him more than me?
No! I had to pay them!
Deciding to literally cut their losses, the boys turn the blade towards her instead. The remarkable aspect of this trap is how so many people are present but are completely helpless, proving how there are no boundaries where Jigsaw is concerned.
Crazy, bro. Imagine seeing this and like just walking down your street. This definitely would be in New York, trash New York. But just imagine just walking down the street and just seeing this trap going on, bro. God damn, I'd be like, hell yeah. I mean, I'd be like, yo, this is a travesty. She for the streets? Dude, there's a kid in front row too.
Yo.
This kid want to see everything, bro. That's insane. Yo, this kid, what is this kid? What kid is this? World star.
Number 6, Mausoleum Trap, Saw 4. This trap doesn't start off with any instructions for the victims.
Talk to me. Okay.
We watch Art Blank come to and realize he's...
I don't know, bro. Like, what if you just woke up and you were in a Jigsaw trap, bro? That would be the worst feeling of all time, bro. The worst feeling of all time, bro. I might just give up. Especially if when he explains what the trap is about and what I have to do, and he just keeps going on and on and on, I'll be like, you got it, bro. Yo, just kill me now, bro. It just in GTA, but like, come on, man. Like, yo, what? I don't even understand. I can't even listen to instructions the first time, bro. You gotta tell me like twice. He cray cray. Jigsaw didn't care about no kids watching. Not at all. He's legit. I'll just legit just give up. Dang, bro. I would be pissed myself at home.
Had his mouth stitched while Trevor, his fellow participant, has had his eyes sealed off. The two have collars attached to their necks that pull them toward a certain doom. Art figures out the key to his victory is placed on Trevor, and the two battle it out before time runs out.
What's wrong with his mouth?
While it seems unfair to Trevor, the true way to win was for Art to communicate with Trevor, since he ended up opening the stitches on his mouth.
I just realized.
The mausoleum trap also signifies how ruthless Jigsaw can be, as it eventually becomes a straight-up death match. Number 5. Glass Coffin.
Yo, we gotta watch a Saw, bro. We gotta watch a Saw.
Hoffman's inheritance of Jigsaw's tactics better than
this. I have not seen Saw 4 and up.
If you are hearing this, then you have once again found what you are looking for. Or so you think.
While Agent Peter Strom gets closer and closer to figuring out Hoffman's
role
as Jigsaw's apprentice, he chases him down to a room containing a glass coffin, which he assumes...
I'm trying to think of... He would trap my ass in a basement. He'd be like, oh, you like making fun of white people? You like making fun of... Well, I got a video game for you.
You're like, wait!
Pick a nose. Like, God damn it, bro. Let's see how much coke you could smoke. Wait, what? Like he would. Yeah, I gotta go back and watch the original too. The key to your escape is behind one of the white people paintings.
Seems to be a trap for himself.
I got you.
However, he realizes his mistake upon playing the tape, as Hoffman reveals the coffin is the only way out.
Your body will never.
I have a pile of cocaine. You have to dig through it with your nose.
No!
You'll be fine. you will simply vanish.
It's here when we learn the actual trap is in the room's walls, which begin closing in as a hapless Strom is left with no way out.
Make your choice.
What makes this so memorable is how Strom was given clues right from the beginning, and that Hoffman had calculated his every move to ensure that he was sealed in this room forever.
That's crazy.
Number 4. Furnace. Saw 2. Aubie is the only person who doesn't panic when the victims of the nerve gas house wake up.
You are breathing in a deadly nerve agent. You've been breathing it since you arrived here.
Later we find out Aubie helped apprehend the others and is forced into a furnace to retrieve the antidotes.
Aubie. It's my name.
Unfortunately for Aubie, his overconfident attitude leads him to underestimating Jigsaw, as he pulls on a chain that activates the furnace and seals him in there.
Oh, shit.
This is one of the first instances where the way to escape is answered in the tape itself, as the devil mentioned by Jigsaw is seen in the furnace. While Aubie meets a painful end, the trap goes a long way in establishing how Jigsaw's traps require victims to play by the rules. Number 3. Acid Room. Saw 6. William Easton is placed in a series of tests where the lives of everyone involved is placed in his hands.
William Neeson.
His motivation to see this through is to reunite with his family, who are implied to be the mother and son watching him. However, the film's twist reveals the family belongs to the man William denied insurance to and died as a result.
You're the man that killed my dad.
It also turns out that the real trap of this game is this one, as the mother-son duo have the option to end William by injecting him with acid.
Or would you dispense the same death sentence he issued your husband?
This trap represents a perfect piece of irony, as William was always responsible for deciding the fate of others, only to find himself begging for mercy. Unfortunately, he gets a lethal taste of his own medicine.
Have mercy, please! Did he show mercy when my husband was suffering?
Number 2.
Fuck your shit,
reverse
lady.
Bear trap. Oh. Saw.
I would have been rooting for her, but damn. That's crazy. Yo, these traps are crazy.
As revealed in Jigsaw, this was among the very first traps the titular villain ever made. The original game is more elaborate, as Amanda is required to beat the time and fish the key out of her cellmate, which is
the
easier said than done.
The iconic trap.
To open the device. It's in the stomach of your dead cellmate.
Ironically, despite the reverse bear trap being the most recurring in the series, we only see its successful execution in the 7th film, although it's well worth the wait. What's interesting is how the trap seems inescapable.
Wait, for real? I thought the first person got out of it, and that's how she became, like, the helper or whatever.
But can be avoided using clever thinking, as later demonstrated by Hoffman. Even more ironic is that it was only used on Jigsaw's apprentices and his own wife, making it the trap that truly tested them as Jigsaw's legacy. Before we unveil our top pick, here are a few other Saw traps that deserve a mention. Rack, Saw 3, because this was a gruesome twist of fate.
Yeah, I remember that. That was crazy.
Steam Maze, Saw 6, because this trap kept the tension at the absolute peak.
Ready?
Yes! Go!
My God, yo, these some crazy-ass traps. Yo, he used it on his own wife. Yeah, in the first one, his wife was like, basically, after she got out of it, she helped him and shit, capture the other people. But they didn't know that till the end. Man, really went all out with this shit show. That's a crazy way to shut your wife up, bro.
It's a box trap. Because this trap was simple yet effective. Necktie Trap, Saw 5. Because the hidden theme of teamwork is what makes this so interesting.
One pull pin starts the timer for all of us.
Megan Good? What
the
hell?
Do that,
I don't remember her.
Now, would you?
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
Yeah.
You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
We all gotta watch it again, bro. Number one,
bathroom trap.
That'd be crazy.
Saw.
Rise and shine, Adam. You're probably
It's on Amazon.
The most
Prime.
Elaborate trap Jigsaw has ever come up with, the bathroom trap is arguably the most iconic one to come out of the series.
Your aim in this game is to kill Adam. You have until 6 on the clock. Do it.
With Lawrence's task to kill Adam and the latter's goal to just survive somehow, the trap is filled with numerous attempts by the men to escape with both their lives intact.
Open it.
It's locked.
The key. The one from my envelope. Where is it?
With the addition of outside factors like Detective Tapp's involvement and Zepp's role in the events, this is a game that keeps us guessing over what the outcome might be.
We have to watch this again, bro. We gotta watch the full. The OG trap, the key was in the freaking, This shit was crazy. Him playing dead. That motherfucker rose up from the bathroom floor and said, game over. Yeah. Holy, I totally forgot about that. He was there the whole time. Holy.
Tonight I went to your house and watched you leave. I followed you.
Its minimalist setting allows the mystery of Jigsaw's identity to remain at the back of our minds. And the finale's twist placed the entire trap in perfect context.
His name is John.
He has an inoperable frontal lobe tumor.
It's also fitting that the original series ends right here to bring everything to full circle, as seen in Saw 3D.
Over.
No!
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from
Fire, bro. Yeah, Saw was just different, bro. After watching the Final Destination stuff and Saw was just different. Holy. My question is how he gets so many equipment and people. I think he's Batman. And he just gets what he wants, you know? And he's white and rich. Oh my gosh, bro. Holy, bro. Oh my god, bro. Wow. Wasn't there something else I was about to look up? I totally forgot, but because that Saw shit was crazy. The Saw. Yeah, Saw changed the game when it came to horror, yeah. Jigsaw had prep time, bro. He literally, if Batman wanted to do this, he could, bro. I can't wait for you to do the greatest video game. Man, fuck you, man. I don't want to let you know what I like. Nah, I will do it, but not today. I am not doing that today. Cause I wanna do the full 100 I wanna do the full thing. I don't got time for that. I wish I was white and rich. You just got one? Damn, you just one out of the two. Actually, you probably none of the two, huh? Because you, aren't you mixed? Oh my gosh. The hell? What the hell is that? Why, bro? Why? This, bro. Oh my god, bro. No games getting played tonight, bruh. I literally was like, yo, I'm about to play this game. We ended up getting no games done. And I'm done with streaming. I will play games tomorrow. Numbers, another sip of CP playing all through summer. Man, they both about the same. So